Space weather affects technologies.
Clear on your final.
As conditions develop, we put out alerts, warnings, and watches to our customers so they can take action.
There's different types of impacts on communication systems. And the HF, we call the high frequency, which is that band of communications 3 to 30 megahertz. But it's a very important band of radio communication because it's used widespread. It's used, for example, by the airlines.
HF radio is most commonly used for position reporting when you're going across the ocean airspace, which is devoid of radar. And ATC can't see you, so it's up to you to report your position and your altitude and your speed.
HF works great most of the time, except during a big flare. And during a big flare, that HF communication capability will be gone within a minute or two. So as soon as we see something happening in there, or we see a flare, it's one of the first things we do is alert the aviation community, hey, big flare, HF's gonna be impacted.
Once we know that there's an event going on, then the aviation industry and the airlines can react to that. They can alter their routes over the poles. They can lower the altitudes that they're flying at, or maybe decide not to fly at all in the interest of their passenger safety.
So that's just one example of how HF is used, but the emergency response community will use it a lot too. It's one of their primary backups.
When you've lost connectivity between certain government agencies, it gives you that long-range coverage to talk from out of state to federal governments or from the FEMA locations to the state emergency operations centers.
So if you've got a big hurricane impact in the coastline, whatever big city, we've got the cell towers down and whatnot, we've got emergency communication folks in there. Those folks are very familiar with space weather and how it impacts their systems.
Here in recent years, it was used during Katrina when we had a lot of communications outages down there. It was also used during Hurricane Ike. There was an outage of the telephone circuits with the Texas State Emergency Office, so it was used in both of those situations.
So when we talk about backup, especially for the airlines, typically they'll have SATCOM, so that'll be satellite communication.
The satellite technology that emergency responders use could be GPSs, could be satellite phones, satellite data terminals.
Space weather events can impact SATCOMs. The impact can range from a nuisance to loss of a spacecraft. So we will give them the heads up. If we have space weather events, flares, whatnot, they need to know what's impacting their systems. Situational awareness is key. Time is of essence to these folks. Again, it's life and death.